Welcome to Pyramid Times. Myself, Veena Surbu, VPR Pyramid Times, and we have with us an amazing guest, dear guest, Master Sri Lakshmi. Master Sri Lakshmi is from UK. She is a meditation coach, abundance coach, and also women empowerment coach. She has been in this spiritual path since 2009. She is also a meditation and mindfulness coach for children. Lakshmi is an inspirational and motivational speaker and a vegetarian promoter. She passionately and intuitively empowers people to release their blocks, connect with their true self, create abundance and stress-free lives they desire. Her main purpose of life is to empower women and children. She helps a lot of people to transform their life through her meditation sessions, workshops, and counseling. With this, I welcome Sri Lakshmi to Pyramid Time Show. Welcome, Sri Lakshmi.
Hi, Veena. Thank you so much for inviting to this wonderful show. I'm super excited.
Yes, and today's topic is going to be on abundance mindset. So, Sri Lakshmi, what do you think about abundance mindset and why people carry poverty mindset most of the time?
Yes, Veena. Here, we have to observe that mind is everything. So we have to start training our mind to expand our awareness. So abundance mindset allows us to see more and more options, more choices, more resources, more opportunities, rather than focusing on our problems. So when we have this abundance mindset, we only see opportunities in any given situation, Veena. And it is like growth mindset. So everyone should adopt this abundance mindset, whatever the situation might be in outside world. When we have this abundance mindset, we start to live in this present moment and we always experience that happy and joy. And we always feel that there are abundance of opportunities for ourselves. So people with this abundance mindset, they are more grateful and they are more appreciative. And when we observe all the spiritual and successful people, they have implemented this. They all have this abundance mindset. So if you take any spiritual organizations like Brahma Kumaris, Sadhguru, or Art of Living, or any spiritual organization, all these organizations are abundant and all spiritual masters are abundant because yogis always live in this present moment and they always have abundance mindset, Veena. And when we observe Patriji also, he doesn't have any single penny in his pocket, but all he has is this abundance mindset. They will be living in that infinite consciousness and have this abundance mindset. Through them, money will be flowing to all the highest possible works for the welfare of the mankind. And also not only the yogis, if you take successful people like Warren Buffett, Tony Robbins, when you read their autobiographies, we know that their goal is not to make more money. Money is secondary to them. They all are like philanthropists and they give back to the society. So they give back a lot to the society in setting up schools, giving their knowledge and providing more jobs to the society. So we need to have this abundance mindset, as the people with this abundance mindset only focuses on growth, opportunities. And the people who live in this scarcity mindset, they all end up with these negative thoughts, creating jealous, envy, guilt. And with all these unwanted thoughts, like I can't do it, I don't have this enough money to do this job or to do this project. So they end up with jealous, envy, and thus spoiling their health. So abundance mindset is very important.
Yes, that's so beautifully told. And sometimes seekers in the spiritual path, they think we should be renunciates, we shouldn't enjoy worldly pleasures, or the money is a hindrance to their growth. But can you shed some light on how to balance these things?
So when we see this money is a part of God's energy, Veena. So in India, when we see money, we represent money as Goddess Lakshmi, right? So God is Lakshmi, God Kubera. So we represent all the gods and goddesses. And we have to always think that money is a form of God's energy, that universal energy. And being spiritual is very important at the same time. So when we live spiritual, we get right understanding about how to spend money for all the highest possible works on this planet Earth. Only spiritual person, only that enlightened person, wise person can use money wisely in their path. So many people have this misconception that all the spiritual people should renounce and they should not have more money, but it is a wrong idea or misconception, Veena. So see, for example, if you have a knife, the knife in the wise person hand, for example, if you have knife, when the doctor uses knife for saving one person life for his surgery, the same knife in the robber in the hands of this robber, he uses this knife for murdering. It is the same knife, same energy, but when this knife is in the right people hands, it will be used wisely. When the same knife, when it is in the wrong people hands, it is used for the wrong things. The same applies with the energy of money. When this energy of money, when it is in the right people hands, like spiritual masters or the wise people, it will be used in the right ways for the welfare of the community.
I think that is beautifully told. I have been recently hearing that if we can have enough for our needs to be met and whatever the desires we have, and rest all excess can be added as a value addition to the planet Earth. It's not that we need not have money and stop contributing to the Earth, but still we can have that money and use it in a wise way, like you have been saying. That's very beautiful. And what is the difference between money and abundance?
As I said, money is a part of this course energy. Money symbolizes this freedom and growth and power. Why we need to earn more money? Because when we have more money, we feel that freedom to enjoy our life. And so that's why we always tend to attract more money into our life. And money is a wonderful tool that communicates between all the organization, all the material things, and in all the human relationships, Veena. But seen as a paper or seen as a coin or seen as a currency, just currency note, money can create this attachment and it can create that fear or lack. But seen as a beautiful energy wave, as I said, money is a beautiful form of God's energy. When we see money as an energy wave, then it can create a beautiful circulation in our life. Beautiful flow of money can happen in our life. But currently the world, the whole world is believing that money is only currency, coins and paper. So we all are giving value to money through our beliefs, through our thoughts and through our mental patterns. When the whole collective consciousness believes money as only note, currency or the coin, then we all are creating this scarcity consciousness, and through this scarcity mindset and consciousness, we have created a lot of problems in this world. See, here money is neutral, Veena, money, as I said, money is a part of God's energy. We have abundance of money in this universe, in this world. But why the rich people are becoming rich and why poor people are becoming poor is because we have programmed. So the collective consciousness need to be changed. As I said, the whole world is believing money as only currency and note. So money itself, the paper, that 500 rupees note or 1000 rupees note itself has no meaning. As I said, the money is energy, and the energy is neutral. When we give positive energy, it starts vibrating with this positive energy. And also I said money is currency. Currency means current, a beautiful energy wave. So there should not be no stagnation of money. So in this whole world, rich people, they are just accumulating the money in their banks and in their boxes. So there is no proper circulation of money. Thus, we are creating so many problems. At the same time, people also, they measure their worthiness based on how much money they have in their lives. But as I said, money, it won't give you good health, good relationship. It can give you success. But when you chase over only money, you lose all this happiness, good relationships, harmonious relationship. Whereas you ask me about what is the difference between money and abundance. Abundance is our true nature. Abundance is our birthright. And so it is like abundance includes everything, Veena. It is our true nature. So it includes love. It includes peace of mind. It includes wisdom, happy relationship, joy, gratitude, that happiness, that satisfaction. So abundance is inner wealth. And true abundance is not at all money. It's a whole feeling of that completeness. It gives you the joy, that freedom, the true core love. So the true meaning of abundance is that love, joy, happiness, freedom. And it is a natural state, and universe is all abundant. And in Vedas also, we have this beautiful statement given in the Vedas. So when you take abundance from the universe, always abundance remains in this universe. So we have abundance of health, money, wisdom, knowledge, success. Money is just a part of abundance.
Yes, That's very beautifully explained. Sometimes most of the people having that greed or jealousy of others having more money, or sometimes people compare and all these things, and they struggle in their own limiting beliefs. Yes. Sometimes it need not be related to even money. It could be related to relationships in terms of health also. How to overcome these limiting beliefs?
So yes, as you said, there are so many limiting beliefs, like if I have this money, I can get that thing and I can buy that thing. If I work hard, so I need to work hard to get more money in my life. These are all so many limiting beliefs that so many people are carrying in their lives. Like if I have more money, I will be having the job security, and people will be believing that my job, it doesn't allow me to earn more income, and money is the root of all the evils. So we have to change all these negative beliefs and start reprogramming all these negative beliefs, the positive beliefs, Veena, positive empowering beliefs. So in my case also, I used to have so many negative belief systems, and I was born in a middle class family, and my father was earning very good income until my 10th grade. So after my 10th grade, my father's financial downfall, it happened. And my mother, she used to say a lot of things to me, like your father is facing so much of difficulties in his financial situation, so we need to spend less money. So as a child, I was given all that programming of scarcity consciousness, and through that limiting scarcity beliefs, I created so many limiting beliefs regarding this money. So I was chasing to get job, unless I realized that I have to connect with my passion. So the moment I started connected with my passion, I started releasing all the negative memories associated with money, and I started reprogramming mind with all this positive belief system, completely redirecting my energy to what I want in my life. So we need to redirect our energies, Veena. Redirecting our energies is very important, because as I said, energy is neutral. Where we focus, that energy is very important. So from my childhood until like five years back, I was completely focusing on this scarcity consciousness, believing that earning money is so hard. Soon as I realized and I erased all my negative beliefs, and I started reprogramming my mind, and I started to believe that as our intent, so is the manifestation. As we think, so we become. So I started giving energy to what I want in my life. And as we all know, that energy flows where our attention goes. So yes, we need to reprogram all these limiting beliefs. So we need to always think positive thoughts, as positive thoughts create all the positive experiences in our mind. And yes, subconscious mind plays a key role in this reprogramming process. I used to always wake up early in the morning, and I used to reprogram my subconscious mind with positive visualizations regarding this money, affirmations, and yes, meditation. Meditation is the key for everything. So by using all these techniques, everyone can reprogram all these limiting beliefs they have about this money.
Yes. So how long does it take for a person to get reprogrammed their subconscious mind to attract more money?
It takes just 21 days. I have been conducting these abundance programs, and in this abundance program, people started experiencing results in just 5 days. So in just 5 days, they started to manifest the dream houses. So we have a lot of testimonials shared in the programs. So yes, it depends upon the person's belief system. So here, strong beliefs plays a key role, Veena. So strong belief is very important in this manifestation process. The more person believes that yes, it is possible, then the manifestation and the reprogramming happens just within a matter of a day, or within few days or few weeks. But at least 21 days is recommended.
That's very beautiful. And most of the times we hear about law of attraction when it comes to manifestation. But half of the people complain that things are not manifesting. Whatever we ask for, it is not given to us. So is it working or not? What do you say?
Law of attraction is working continuously 24/7, whether we believe it or not. As So there are so many laws in this universe: law of attraction, law of gravitation, law of cause and effect, and law of constant evolution. So we have so many laws, Veena. But yes, law of attraction is absolutely working. So the main thing we need to notice whether this law of attraction is working or not is by checking our feelings. So feelings are the best indicators. When you think of your wish, for example, you have set an intention to manifest your dream job. So the moment you think of your intention, the moment you think of your wish, you need to get that happy feeling, happy vibration. Then it is indicated that the manifestation is happening and it is in process. The moment you think about your job, when you're getting this worry, jealous, fears, or whether it may happen or not, then you need to check. And replace all these low-based thoughts with, again, the positive thoughts. So feelings are the best indicators, Veena. So the more doubts we have, we need to change. We need to reprogram our mind with all the trusty-based belief systems, because law of attraction is constantly working, whether you are putting positive thoughts into the universe, whether you are putting fears. So when you have more fears, you are constantly attracting that fearful situations in your life. When you have more negativity, you are attracting constantly that negativity in your life. So since law of attraction is completely working, so when we have more resistance in our life, the resistance is manifesting in our life. So we should be very careful of our thoughts. What we are thinking, what we are projecting into this universe is very important. Yes, law of attraction is happily working, Veena.
That's so beautifully put. You emphasized on resistance. Most of the people are desperate that things should happen, or they hold through that, they pull in a lot of resistance instead of letting go of things to happen on its own. Yes. And can you share some of your manifestations in the last 5 years?
Yes, as I said, previously I used to focus on all the painful situations in my life. The more I focused on this pain, suffering, why I'm unable to manifest my job, why I'm creating all this suffering. As I started focusing on the painful memories, I constantly started reaping that painful situations into my life. As I said, more painful situations, more painful experiences in my life. I started using full moon meditations, new moon meditations, and also doing this 41 days, 21 days meditations regularly. So by doing all these things, I completely shifted my mind to the positive thoughts. The more I thought of thinking these positive thoughts, I got energized. All these positive thoughts got energized and multiplied, Veena. So I used to just close my eyes, visualize what I want to manifest in my life. And I used to feel it in my heart, feel it in my mind. And I used to have the joyful, happy emotion when I think of that thought. So by doing this, by letting go of what I want, I started manifesting so many things in my life. So I started connecting with my passion. Now I work as a music teacher here. I teach just thrice or four times a week, just for 45 minutes. Now I'm earning a good amount of income just connecting with my passion. See, my passion has given me so much of abundance in my life. And also, I said, abundance is like manifesting abundance in each and every area of my life. I heal my PCOD by aligning completely with this abundance energy. You can call it as abundance energy, universal energy, infinite energy. Energy is same, my dear friends. So the more you get aligned and focus and heal. So by using this abundance energy, I started healing each and every area. I started manifesting the apartment now I'm living. I started manifesting 3 lakhs laptop. I started manifesting my job. So many things. I started manifesting more of my spiritual workshops and classes just by aligning what I want to manifest in my life. So this abundance energies helped me to do so many things. Like recently I did 111 days of Global Goddess Meditation Circle with 111 feminine masters across the globe. It is such a huge project. It's an abundance project. Why I'm able to do that project is because of my abundance energies.
That's very beautiful. You yourself are a role model for many people to tread the path of abundance. And do you have any other role models, or do you suggest any role models in your own life on this abundance mindset?
Yes, my all-time role model is Patriji, Brahmarshi Patriji. He is a grand spiritual scientist. Just by living in his presence and just by observing this grand master, I learned so many things in my life. So when we connect with the right masters, then we are in the right path, Veena. So just by observing Patriji, he is the epitome of this miraculous manifestations. He always vibrates with this miraculous energy. He has created so many projects with this miraculous mindset. So just by observing Patriji, I started implementing my life. He is my inspiration. He is my role model. And yes, I am truly grateful to Patriji for helping me to live the life the way I desired.
That's very beautiful. So how can we have a balanced life of both material and spiritual at the same time attract more money into our lives?
Being grateful, Veena. So gratitude plays a key role here. So be grateful to all the blessings in your life. Forgive others and invite that energy of money into your life. For example, when you want to invite some guests into your house, how happily you invite them. So you have to invite that money energy into your life. You have to welcome that money energy into your life with so much of happiness and gratitude. First of all, count all the blessings in your life so far you have received in your life. Then start inviting that energy of money. Money is an energy. It will be vibrating in a beautiful frequency. So we have to be in this vibrational match. So we have to attract that frequency of money into our life. And the frequency and the energy and the vibration of money is nothing but the happiness and gratitude, my dear friends. When you feel that happiness and joyful, when you vibrate with that higher vibration, then it leads to successful manifestation. So raising our vibration is very important. So make sure to incorporate happiness and gratitude in your life. Be committed and be determined and don't at all focus on any low vibrational frequencies, my dear friends. So like why I'm unable to manifest it. Earning money is very important. It is not possible with me. All these thoughts create negative blocks in your life. So everything starts with a thought, and thought is an energy, my dear friends. Always focus on the positive things. For example, when you're seeing this mobile is a beautiful thought in one person's mind. So after having a thought about the money, after setting intention about the money, feeling and emotion plays a key role in manifestation process, my dear friends. So first step is setting an intention, like I happily and successfully manifested my desired job. I happily and successfully manifested my dream house. It is like your beautiful intention. Add that feeling and emotion to it. So then money automatically flows into your life where there is happiness and a beautiful emotion. So these are the three steps. Have a beautiful set and beautiful intention and incorporate that happy feeling and the beautiful gratitude emotion. Then manifestation is yours, my dear friends.
That's very beautifully said, like seeing as if it is already happened and experiencing the feelings and emotions that come out of it. It's very beautifully put. And what kind of workshops and sessions do you offer to the public?
So yes, currently I'm taking workshops, this abundance meditation workshops in English and Telugu, Veena. Soon we are going to launch it in Tamil also. We are getting tremendous results. I'm doing this 21 days of abundance mindset programming sessions. And so far I have completed three sessions. Now I'm planning for future sessions.
That's very beautiful. And can you share also a couple of testimonials, like how people got benefits attending these workshops?
Oh my goodness. The moment I started doing these sessions, recently I finished this 21 days of abundance meditation sessions in Telugu yesterday. So I'm getting tremendous results. So many people manifested so many things in their lives. They started to get back their money, which they have given to many of their relatives long time ago. And that relatives, they are not at all responding to them. So by participating in these sessions, most of the people recovered their money, like 25 lakhs, 40 lakhs, 15 lakhs. And many people started receiving their unexpected money, like $1,500. and the people started healing the relationships. As I said, abundance is of true nature. It is like it is holistic approach, Veena. So some people started healing their relationship, healing their diseases. When we did this abundance workshop in English, people started to win their lottery, increase in the salary hike, and receiving that unexpected money, manifesting the dream house. So there are so many hundreds of testimonials, Veena. So I'm so happy and grateful that universe has chosen me to do this job, to help many people to attract and to live their life with this wonderful true abundance.
Okay. Can you tell us who are the inspiration to continue our thread on this path of abundance mindset?
Yes, Veena, thank you for this question. And yes, as I said, I was completely aligned with this abundance consciousness, but it was in my back end and I was not completely focusing on these energies, but universe is trying to pull me into this track. During that time, one organization from Kuwait, they approached me to do this paid workshop, but I was not prepared to do. As I was busy, I was postponing this project. And during that time, again, Pari brought up with this great initiative of this, doing this 30 days of abundance mindset program through PSSM Global. So yes, that program has really shifted me, my consciousness, and truly aligned me to this path to do this work. So universe has given me opportunity, and I'm so thankful to Pari Patri for thinking of me for this project. And we both rocked this project. Yes.
Yeah. And how can people reach out to you?
Yes. I have my YouTube channel, Sri Lakshmi Abundance. And same in Facebook, Instagram, Telegram with the same name, Sri Lakshmi Abundance.
Sure. We will put the links below this video. You can go and check out all the information related to Sri Lakshmi. And it's very beautiful listening to you, Sri Lakshmi. You have shared wonderful tips. And if you can share a couple of gratitude and happiness related tips to the users.
So the moment you wake up early in the morning, don't look at your mobiles, my dear friends, because when you look at your WhatsApp or Facebook, the person who has typed that message, he will be vibrating at one frequency. So when he was typing that message, we don't know at what frequency he was when he was typing that message. So the moment you wake up and see the message, you will be attracting to the frequency of the word that he has emitted while he was typing. So don't look into the WhatsApp or Facebook. The moment you start, close your eyes and start your day with full of gratitude. See, I'm so thankful to universe for one more beautiful day in this beautiful chapter of my life. So be thankful to your house, to your parents, to your children, to your family members, to Mother Earth, to Mother Universe. And also send that light energy to all your projects and to all your works that you want to do today. And yes, by the end of the day, end your day with being in that happy mode, as if you have manifested all your dream jobs. So because with what thought you're sleeping at night, the same thought, the same frequency we are carrying whole night. Right. So blessings, gratitude, start your day with this counting your blessing and end with your day with this happy vibration, as if you have manifested all your dreams. So then manifestation is very easy and fun. So do this manifestation process as if you're doing in that playful way. Don't be so serious about your manifestations. Always be playful. Do with so much of fun, joy, celebrate your manifestation process.
This was very beautifully put. And any final message for the viewers?
Yes, friends, please do meditation. Please be a vegetarian. As Earth is going through a tremendous healing, so as we are in this beautiful transition phase, I request everyone to do meditation and to be a vegetarian. And do watch Pyramid Times and all of our PMC channels. And please do subscribe.
Yes, thank you so much, Sri Lakshmi, for joining us today. Thank you so much.